again, it just seems perfectly clear that Cowling wants everybody to be calm. Just going to ask everybody to be quiet for a moment. We have on the phone with us as well Robert Higgins, who lives in the neighborhood and is on the ground and can see inside the van. Mr. Higgins.
How are you?
Just about as tense as you are, sir.
Oh, my Lord, this is quite the tensest.
What can you see?
Oh, what I'm looking at right now is I'm looking at the van and I see OJ kind of slouching down, looking very, very upset. Now, looky here, he looked very upset. I don't know what he's going to be doing.
Can you see him doing anything specific? Is he merely sitting there?
He is just sitting around, you know, just looking like he'd be very nervous.
Can you hear anything, Mr. Higgins?
It's just too much commotion. I'd be in the back of a news van, so I can't really hear that good, but I can see it all. And I see OJ. I see OJ, man, and he looks scared. And I would be scared because there's cops all deep in this.
Thank you, Mr. Higgins.
And baba booey to y'all.
The driveway of O.J. Simpson's home in Brentwood. Clearly an effort being made to have him come out of the vehicle. In the doorway of the house, his friend, Al Cowling.
Peter, by the way, just for the record, this is Al Michaels. That was a totally farcical call. Lest anybody think that that was somebody who was truly across the street. That was not. He said something in code at the end that's indicative of the mentioning of the name of a certain radio talk show host.
Okay, thanks, Al.
So he was not there.
All right, we have them on every coast. Thank you very much. Not the first time nor the last time we'll have been had, but... If the police do get their hands on O.J., he will be taken to the Los Angeles County Men's Jail, where he will be held until a preliminary hearing is held, which is normally 2 weeks after he's arraigned. You probably already know from earlier today that various blood samples from the scene of the crime match his, but other blood samples of his have been sent away for a more intense DNA analysis. There's been all sorts of talk all week about pieces of evidence here, pieces of evidence there. The district attorney said earlier this evening that while the murders had been committed with a knife, a fairly substantial knife, they did not have possession of the murder weapon.
Peter, there have been some...
Barbara, quiet for a second, please. Sorry. My apologies, but
yes.
He's coming out.
Okay.
I believe. Where is... Sorry, go ahead, please, Barbara. No, it's Cowling again. Sorry, Barbara, go ahead.
There have been some reports that when he is arraigned, that he would be in the cell next to Eric Menendez, which is currently empty. This is what we had heard today, and it's just something to add to what might happen in the future.
Al Michaels and the district attorney have all said it. So eloquently, this is just excruciatingly sad. Yes, indeed, tense, full of sadness. Sadness for the victims, for the children, who of course are also victims. And so sad to see a man who has represented so much to Americans through his example. Some of his examples, because spousal abuse is anything but an example to be admired, and that aspect of his private behavior, and in one case his public behavior, have only recently come to light for the great majority of us who've not paid that close attention to him in latter years.
Peter,
just to people who've just joined us, in case now, we are looking at a white Bronco in the driveway of O.J. Simpson's home in Brentwood, Los Angeles.
In which he's charged.
Which has come to a stop there several minutes ago.
Conclusion of all of this, we'll be back.
Tour of the Los Angeles freeways, this vehicle, accompanied by an enormous number of police cars, police helicopters, and in the one case for us, the Channel 5 KTLA TV news helicopter. And that's where they have been so far on a manhunt that's lasted more than 5 hours. Earlier today, O.J. Simpson was charged with two counts of murder with special circumstances. They have been driving around. Nobody quite knew where he was going. They thought he might at one point be going to his mother. There'd clearly been some speculation when he disappeared from a residence where he had been in seclusion for the last several days, last 3 days anyway, according to Al Michael, that he might even be trying to leave the country. He's with his friend Al Collings, who we went to school with at USC and played with on the Buffalo Bills, trying to coax him out of that car, or at least trying to create the circumstances by which he might come out of the car.